Hi, in this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to write for four-part voices, that is SATB, with figure base given. It is taken from ABRSM Grade 6, 2021A Question 2. I'll show you in four steps. Let's get started. Step 1 is to look at the key, then write out the Roman numerals, and then the soprano line. In the key signature given is no sharp and no flat. That means either C major or A minor. By confirming it with the first note A in the bass, and also the A in the last bar, we confirm that this is in A minor. If you wish, you can write out the triads in A minor, like this. Either in the staff or in letter names. But make sure you understand that there is a G sharp because this is in A minor. And remember, leading note is always raised. Now let's look at the bass line. The bass line is given. If you are at home, then you can play it on the piano, or if you are in an exam or in a classroom, you can hum it in your mind and recognize the sofar name also. By realizing the figure base, we understand that without any figure, that means that is the root position of a chord. If it is a 6, that means first inversion. If it is 6-4, it will be second inversion. In minor key, we will always recognize that there will be a sharp in the figure bass. That means the third from the bass, in this case, is a G sharp. The third note has to be sharpened. Let's go to the first note in bass. This is A in root position. So definitely this is ACE chord. And we write it in Roman numerals, lowercase. This is the first inversion, so we can recognize the chord tone as A-C-E. So this is still one chord in B position. The third quaver with a sharp, that means the third from the bass has to be sharpened. And we can recognize that this chord tone is E-G-sharp-B. E is the fifth note. So this is a dominant chord here. The next one is also a 6, so the chord tone is B, D, F. B is the second note, so it should be a 2B. And remember, 2B in minor scale, this is a diminished chord. Then the next one is a C with a 6, and we have done it before, so this is 1B. The 4B here, because of the 6, we can recognize D, F, A. So it's a 4B. Then this is 5 again with the sharp. This A without any figure, that means root position, A, C, E. It's a 1 chord. And 4B again. In here, there's a 6 sharp. That means the 6th note from the bass, which is the G, has to be sharpened. And the G sharp is the seventh note in A minor. So it should be the seventh chord, B position. Then goes to 1B. And this little semi-quaver D with a continuous line here means that this is just a passing note. Then the final one is a 1C5-1. If you have watched my previous video 1C5 song, then you will understand that this 1C is a decoration of 5 and it is always used before the final cadence. So 1C5. Then this 5, because of the leading note here, so that means the G has to be sharpened. So every time when we have this 1C5, we have to write out the full figure bass 6, 4, and 5 sharp. The final A is very special. There is a sharp in here. That means the third from the bass, which is a C, has to be sharpened. As we know that in minor key, 5-1 is usually in lowercase 1, which means a minor quality tonic triad or tonic chord. But now change the third or raise the third a semitone, it becomes a major quality, it becomes a major chord. This is done very frequently and a common practice in Baroque period. It is called tierce de picardie. So just remember this special characteristic, and it is quite often appears in minor key compositions. Now let's look at the soprano line. How to do a soprano line? The first priority is to go contrary with the bass. And after several or not more than three times, then we can go similar motion. And after a while, we can go back to contrary motion. So as a conclusion, to make the melodic line with ups and downs, with good contour lines, and also have independence with the bass. Now, if we have the bass A to C, which is a reposition to first inversion, it is quite common to get the soprano contrary motion with it. So when you have an A and C, you just go contrary C to A. This would be good. Then the next chord is a 5, and it is quite comfortable to put a G sharp after the tonic note here. Then go to this 2B. The chord tones are B, D, F. So I will choose a B here to make a contrary motion. If I put an F down here, I will cause an augmented second here. And usually in four-part writing in the Baroque period, we avoid all the augmented intervals. So after this, we go to 1B and A, C, E. I will just put an A, and you will see they are of parallel movement, but this is a six apart. So this is parallel six. In four-part writing, parallel third and parallel six sounds good because they are consonants. So don't be afraid when you have parallel third or parallel six. Then the next one, I try to move up a little bit because I want to make a climax in the middle of the phrase. So this one I choose from the 4B chord, it's D, F, A. I will just put a D over here. Then continue to go up, although they are the same note here, 5 chord, but go contrary motion is always fine. Then finally, go up to 5-1, and I can continue to do contrary motion. 4B, I choose a D on top, D, F, A. After contrary motion, I'll go similar motion. So this is a G sharp, B, and D. Since this is a D, if I go up to G sharp, it will be augmented fourth. So avoid this, and I will just choose a closer note that is a B. And go contrary motion with the bass, this chord A, C, E. And finally, with the 1C5-1, it's quite common to have this. So do ti la, the la is the tonic. It is good to put a tonic note in the soprano line. So this is quite a common ending with 1C5. Let's listen to these two parts together. Now, let's go to step 2. Step 2 is to fill in the alto and the tenor first for the first two bars only, and then jump to the final ending to finish the 1C5-1 first. So how to fill in the alto and tenor is to remember inner parts go smoother. If you have the same note, you just keep it, or resolve to the nearest possible note. So this 1 and 1B, I just need an A and E to fulfill the full chord AACE. So since this inner part is the same, I can just combine the two quavers into one crotchet, and it is quite a common practice. Unless there are lyrics in between, otherwise we can combine the two repeated notes. Then come to this 5, E, G sharp, B. Since I have a G sharp already, I cannot double the leading note. So double the root is the first priority, E, E, G sharp, B. Then goes to 2B, 2 is a B. D, D, you can see I double the third, B, D, D, F. 2B is always good to double the third, and it is quite the first priority. When we go to 1B, check the note A, C, E, E. And this time you'll find that I double the fifth. I double the fifth, it's okay when the previous part go by contrary motion. And so I will just continue to go up because of the climax later on. So this D, D, F, A. You can see I have two Ds, that means double the root. And it is go by contrary motion. So no parallels at all. Now we put the third bar aside and jump to the ending 1C5-1. As we follow the pattern, this is Mi, Mi, La, Do. And then I go Mi, Mi, Si, Ti. So you can see they resolve by step in the soprano and the alto. Then you keep the same note. This is not called parallels because this is just remains the same note. So it is not called parallels. All right. So after that, we'll go to a one chord. A, A, C sharp, E. This is the leading note. Although we said leading note always go up to the tonic, but in the inner part and in Bach style, he always goes to the fifth of this tonic chord. A, C, E. E is the fifth. So this is okay. All right, so this is step 2. Now we come to step 3. Look at the third bar. To connect this A goes to G sharp is quite smooth because of the leading note. Then we need to have a B in the tenor, E, E, G sharp, B. This one looks like a fifth, but it is not a parallel fifth because this tenor and bass is a 6, so there's no parallel fifth here. Then goes to 5-1, A, 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 C. You can see that this tonic chord, I have triple tonic. This A, A, tenor and bass sings the same note, unison, but it's always okay to have 3 tonics and 1/3 in the soprano. Right. Then we can move on to 4B, D, D, F, A. After that, 7B to 1B. So remember in the inner part, when I put the G, remember to put the G sharp. This is the leading note sharpened. So G sharp, B, I double the third, and 7B is always good to double the third. Then the D is just a repetition of here. And resolve to 1B, A, C, E. The A is double here, singing unison for soprano and alto. Then check the horizontal resolution. It's okay to go to 1C. All right, then we can connect them smoothly. Now we are done with this step 3. If you feel satisfied, actually we can stop here. But if you want to challenge yourself to touch up a little bit and add more decorations, I'll show you in step 4. Step 4 is a final touch up and add decorations. Let's compare this alto E and E. We can change this into a dotted crotchet so that the rhythmic pattern is more interesting. Then as we come to the third bar, I can put a passing note here, D to B. So it becomes D, C, B. And you can find the da, 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 dum rhythm is copying the bass here. Da, da, da. And then finally, I will add another passing note so that I can continue with this da, 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 da. All right, so it makes more interesting, like a conversation. Each part have their own movement and they imitate each other. Then I can also join the repeated notes to make it like a syncopation. All right, and make sure that double check with the C sharp at the end. And one last reminder is when you have a leading note here, go to an E. Although this is a third apart, in Bach's style or in the Baroque period, we never put a passing note here. The G sharp is the leading note. Just go directly to the fifth of this tonic chord. Leading note in the inner part, that means maybe alto or maybe tenor. Just go to the fifth of the tonic chord. Don't add a passing note here. All right, so we are done. Then we can listen to this four part. All right, this is a demonstration of how to write SATB with figure base given. Thanks very much for watching, and if you find it helpful or interesting, please subscribe, like, and share.